بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله، الحمد لله رب العالمين، منور أبصار العارفين بنور المعرفة واليقين، وجاذب قلوب عباده الصالحين بجذبات القرب والتمكين، الذي أحسن كل شيء خلقه وبدأ خلق الإنسان من طين. والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين وإمام النبيين ورحمة الله للعالمين، سيدنا ومولانا وشفيعنا وحبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك وتمنن وتحنن وتعطف وتلطف على أكمل مخلوقات الله سيدنا محمد، صلاة ترضيك وترضيه وترضى بها عنا في جمعنا هذا، في مجلسنا هذا، في مكاننا المبارك هذا، في شهر شعبان هذا، بما رضيت به عن عبادك الصالحين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. الحمد لله وذ الله بركه سبحانه وتعالى. We've been blessed to be here tonight in this very special month, in a very special majlis, in a very special place, in Nashr al-Quran, where the beginning and end started from the Quran, started from Iqra, read, and end by the Quran as well. May Allah grant us the barakah of Al-Quran to be as Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to recite, Allahumma aj'al al-Quran al-Kareem rabi'a qalbi. Allahumma aj'al al-Quran rabi'a qulubina. He said, make Ya Allah the Quran the spring of my heart. What the meaning of spring? Spring, you will feel happy, nice weather, everything is growing. Let the benefit and barakah of Quran grow always, every moment and each second in my heart. Until we reach, inshallah, to be among those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about them, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ. May Allah bless our hearts with tranquility through the Holy Quran, so that we can find peace each and every moment in our life. So I would like to say thank you so much for Nashr al-Quran, especially our beloved Datu Latif, Jazahullah Khair, and Sidi Sheikh Abdullah, Barakallah Fikum, Al-Habaib, and all of you dear brothers and sisters, for giving us the opportunity to be here to talk for a short while about something very, very, very great. Because why I said great, when you talk about Al-Isra wal-Mi'raj, it's showing us something different. Something different for us to know about Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and about ourselves as well. Whatever Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam got, anything, any blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we will get also the benefit for all of us. When you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ab'athu Allahumma al-maqam al-mahmood al-ladhi wa'atta, Ya Allah, in the sino after azan, Ya Allah, bless him with the highest position you have promised him. What is our benefit? When he got al-maqam al-mahmood, all the ummah will get the barakah as well, inshallah. So al-Isra wal-Mi'raj is something very special to talk about. In this few minutes, we try to highlight about the meaning of servanthood, Abdullah, as Allah described him in the Quran, in this holy journey. Al-Isra wal-Mi'raj, subhana alladhi asra bi abdihi, his servant, no title, nothing. His relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as servant. His relationship with us as a prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Which is the highest one? Being Abdullah. Because when you are Allah's servant, Allah will open the door of everything for you. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. Let this oneness be in our heart, Ya Allah. The oneness of ibadah all the time. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said subhan from beginning, tasbih won't be only in only Allah will mention about tasbih and something great that nobody can do, only Him. You see, in our life, when we see anything unusual, extraordinary, luar biasa, we say, Subhanallah. What is this? Subhanallah. Tamam? So when Allah said Subhan, you mean the journey, the whole trip by Him, Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So no one can question why, when, how, what for. Subhan. Alladhi asra. Who's the one who asked to come? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked him to come. Now, if you ever have the opportunity to invite VVIP to your house or your organization or your company for any function, you'll be, you know, proud of that. And you'll invite special people to attend, those close people to you. And those people maybe not close to you also, for them to be close to you after that, to see that the VIP attended your function. But when we see that the celebration here is something different, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam al-Isra all the way to be the Imam in Masjid al-Aqsa and then to go to heaven to all the angels and Allah's Prophet. What is this? Celebration for Rasulullah, arranged by whom? By Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi al-mathal al-a'la. It's different being you invite VVIP and different being VVIP invite you to his palace to celebrate you. Wallahi al-mathal al-a'la. To Allah's greatest example. And when we say mu'jizatul Isra wal Mi'raj, we say mu'jizat, صح? The miracle, one of the most important conditions of miracle is that it should happen and the people can see that by their eyes. I have to see the mu'jizah so that for the believer, their iman will be stronger to strengthen their iman. And for the non-believer, to see something extraordinary. Like what's happened to all al-anbiya wal-mursaleen. Most of the miracles happen, most of them, not all, most of them happen, the miracles happen to al-mursaleen, and the people saw that. And mainly the non-believers. Sayyidina Ibrahim, the miracle of when they put him in fire. Sayyidina Musa, the stick. Many. Either to witness by the people, his follower, and most of the time by non-believers. So they can see that this is something extraordinary. Like the magician, when Fir'aun got all of them to come to challenge Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, they were very proud. So they asked him, you know, would you like to be the first to try to throw the... No, you try first. So they were like very, you know, they're sure for them they're going to win. So they throw their robes. And when he throw his stick and start swallowing all the robes, they realize, because they're magicians, they know the tricks. They say, this is not a trick. This is real miracle. قَالُوا آمَنَّا بِرَبِّ مُوسَى وَهَارُونَ Immediately. Allah, this is not, we know what is. So it have to be witnessed by the people. Now, Isra al-Mi'raj witnessed by whom? By only him. Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Sahih? No one saw that, only him. Sayyidina Jibreel, no one can see him and to tell us what to tell. Only him. So to show what? This is a special mu'ajizah khas to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ahlul ilm, as-salihin, ahlul athwaq, they say, this miracle to show Muhammad, the reality of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Al-abd. See, Allah said, subhanallah, asra bi'abdihi. He never mentioned the name. Didn't say like Abdullah Zakaria, Abdullah Ayyub, the name, when he said my servant, so and so. Huh? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Sayyidina Rasulullah, subhanahu alladhi asra bi abdihi, alhamdulillah alladhi anzala ala abdihi. Never mentioned, why? No one will come to your mind as the top of Allah's servant like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For example, if you go to a military camp, in the military camp, they are leaders. Someone who lead 10 soldiers, we call him leader. Someone who lead 100, also leader. Someone 1,000, leader. 10,000, leader. So anyway, they are all leaders. But when you go to that military camp and you say to the reception, the officer, I want to meet the leader, without mentioning his name, which one will come to his mind? The commander, the top one, without mentioning the name. So when you say Subhanalladhi asra bi abdihi, no one will come to our mind, only Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is a top. وَمَنْ أَعْبَدُ مِنِّي. Humbleness. And this is something very extraordinary. Sayyidina Rasulullah, with his humbleness, Allah elevated him to the heaven, Mi'raj. And there is someone else who takabbur, mutakabbirin, proud. She showed the proud in the heaven. Allah put him down on earth. Sayyidina Rasulullah, the one who elevated him because of his Allah's servant to the heaven. Iblis came down because he's illa Iblis aba was takbar, na'udhu billah. So the miracle of being Allah's servant, it's totally linked now to understand. Now we're going to see how it is also for us to understand that there is a link between servanthood and mi'raj and ourselves. When Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam came back from al-mi'raj, he brought for us two things. For the ummah. One, the last few verses of Surah Al-Baqarah. Sahih? Amana ar-rasulu bima unzila ilayhi min rabbihi. To the end. The second one, the fard. One, the only fard obligatories which was became a. When? Which one is that? As-salah. Okay, as-salah contain what? Qiyam, ruku' and sujood. Sahih. Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the heaven, he saw the angels. Many of them in the situation of qiyam from the time Allah created them until end of the life. Their tasbih, subhanallah walhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah Allah akbar subhanallah walhamdulillah wa la ilaha, like breathing for us. You know, we breathe, cannot stop. The angels also like that. Tasbih, subhanallah, walhamdulillah. But the rahba, the jalal of saying by angels, something different. Now, if all of us get together now and you say, subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, Allah akbar, you will feel something. Let us try, for example. Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar, subhanallah. I want to hear. سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله سبحان الله والحمد سبحان الله عجيب. The angel from the time Allah created them until the end of the life, in their قيام, ركوع or سجود, in one position only. One, قيام, ركوع or سجود. And they will elevate their heads. They will raise their heads when Sayyidina Israfil alayhi salam blew in the horn في الصور, and will say, Ya Allah, subhanaka ma abadnaka haqqa ibadatik ya ma'bud. Ya Allah, forgive us as we have done nothing to worship you. They know al-maqam. We know what? We know ourselves, maqam of ourselves. But Allah said, unless you become humble and my servant, I want you your reality. As-salat, this salat, no matter how you are, no matter how wealthy you are, and no matter what position you have, all of us ruku' and sujood. You have to put your forehead in the ground and to say Subhan Rabbi al-A'la. Subhan Rabbi al-A'la. No matter how you are, who you are. But you know what? Our salat contain qiyam, ruku' and sujood combined together. The positions of ibadah of angels, they have only one, either qiyam or ruku'. Ours all in one. A gift from Allah to us to be His humble servants for us to reach to the qurb to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, nearness to Him. Bi'abdihi. There is a man in the time of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was a chief of one tribe called Bani, they call it Bani Usaid. Big tribe. One of the biggest tribes of Arabia those days. He came to Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he wants to convert to Islam. But he was a king, the chief king. So when he came to Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and asked him, I want to become a Muslim. So, la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, khalas. What is next? As-salah. How to pray? Qiyam. Okay. Ruku'. He said, hey, wait a minute, ya Rasulullah. I am a king. I won't bow to anyone. The people bow to me. How to bow to? He doesn't know anything yet. Sayyidina Rasulullah took from him 23 years to change. Huh? And now we want to change 23 minutes. So he said to Sayyidina Rasulullah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send him with rahmah, rahmah al-alameen, idu'u ala sabi rabbika bil-hikmah, wal-maw'idha al-hasana. He said to him, I won. So what Sayyidina Rasulullah said to him, he said, go from here, Allah doesn't want you. No. He didn't say there is sujood. He ruku', he's not. How about sujood? Ah, that's okay. Okay, don't pray, don't ruku' and sujood. He doesn't know anything. So he entered to the circle of blessings. Zikr from here, ma'idah from here, the environment of Sahaba, and you know, different story. One of the names of Sahaba, one name is equal to mountains. Sayyidina Rasulullah said, if we put the iman of the ummah in one hand of scale and the iman of Abu Bakr in the other hand, iman of Bakr will be heavier. Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mas'ud was very small person, very small size. His leg was very thin. If you see it, you will laugh. And one day he was with Sahaba going up to the Jabal of Uhud with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And some of them saw his leg. So they a bit like, you know, laughed. So Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Wallahi, meaning, you know, he is heavier than Uhud. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. One person. Mu'adh bin Jabal. Allahu Akbar. Sayyidina Rasulullah, what's here? He said to him, Ya Mu'adh, Wallahi inni la uhibbuk. Allahu Akbar. Sayyidina Rasulullah said to him, Ya Mu'adh, Wallahi I love you. Ajib ya akhi. Who is this people? So he was this person, the mutakabbir, you know, he was in this environment, in the greatest school in the world. School of Sahaba or Ahl Bayt, because it has the best principle in the world, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So later on, you know what's happened to him? He became the person whom his sujood the longest among all. His sujood, the longest. Sayyidina Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jailani, Qaddasa Allah sirrahu, said, the beauty of sujood is that you whisper. No one knows what you are saying, whispering. But your dua being heard in earth and in heaven. You whisper, subhanAllah, nobody knows, but Allah listening. And we want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us. And we have the best thing to do, as-salat. Sayyidina Rasulullah brought it for us. This is to connect with Allah. Direct connection. There is no busy. Direct number 24434. Salat 24434. 2 Fajr, 4 Adhur, Asr, 3 Maghrib, 4 Isha. 24434. Khalas. Ma'Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. See, Sayyidina Rasulullah, when we talk about all these meanings, we have to know the situation he was crossing. In one time, he have lost both Abu Talib, the one who was protecting him, يعني, as a human being, outside the house, and he lost Sayyidina Khadija, radiallahu anha, the one who was giving him hope and kindness inside the house, until they called that Aam al-Huzn, the year of sadness. So now, and then he went to a Taif, Ahl al-Taif, you know how they throw him with a stone, and now, gone. When you are in a deep difficulties, wait for Allah's help. Inna ma'al usri yusra. You will see. Inna ma'al usri yusra. You will see my help now. Ya Rasulullah, come I show you something different. You have seen the rudeness of Ahlul Earth. They are very rude. The people of earth. I will show you now the welcoming of Ahlul Sama. عجيب. After 571 years from سيدنا عيسى عليه السلام, this zikr and tasbih and you know, gone. No one reminded of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If someone who to remind somebody, if someone to make you know, they have to be one very wealthy man or something. Now سيدنا رسول الله came in different, he changed so much things. The angels would love to see him. Link that to سيدنا آدم عليه السلام, the story when they said, when Allah created سيدنا آدم, and the angel said, Ya Allah, قالوا وتجعل فيها من يفسد فيها ويسفك الدماء. Am I going to create someone? قال إني أعلم ما تعلمون. The same angels who they have said that, they are the one who have seen سيدنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And they are the one who instructed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه. اللهم صلي وسلم بارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. So this something, there is something here. When you are in deep difficulties, the help will come. And what help? Nothing. The people are, you know, خلاص. Now what Allah show him? See, read the verse, when you read it carefully, Allah said, سُبْحَانَ الَّذِي أَسْرَى بِعَبْدِهِ لَيْلًا مِنَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ. Question, Mecca was masjid at that time? Huh? No one, no believer. Al-Muhajirin, all of them, those whom they got, 80 something, all of them. 13 years, 80 something, Al-Muhajirin. Difficulties, nothing, no, خلاص. But Allah said, Ya Rasulullah, Mecca will be masjid. MashaAllah, ajib, Ya Allah. He said, no. Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa, Jerusalem, also will be masjid. What else you want? Subhanallah, الَّذِي يَسْرَى بِعَبْدِهِ لَيْلًا مِنَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ إِلَى الْمَسْجِدِ الْأَقْصَى. So why Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa? Why not straight? الإمام الشعراوي رحمه الله, سيدنا الإمام الشعراوي يفسر القرآن, أهل القرآن, we are نشر القرآن, mentioning the name of أهل القرآن, الله, one of them, الإمام محمد بن تملي الشعراوي رحمة الله عليه, he said, when Allah decided that مسجد الأقصى going to be مسجد, and it's gifted to سيدنا رسول الله to know that, he have to attend the opening ceremony, صلى الله عليه وسلم. So I went there to attend the opening ceremony of Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. And he is a VVIP. Who's a VIP? Al-Anbiya wal-Mursaleen. Salla bihim imam sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Great celebration of your beloved Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How many times we recite salawat upon him? We are losing all this barakah. When his name mentioned a few times, we think that one time we say Allah, when we hit the beginning of lecture, his name, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that's all. No, ya akhi. The more you recite salawat upon him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the more nearness you will get, inshallah. Position, bi-idhnillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا لنوريه من آياتنا إنه هو السميع البصير. Ya Rasulullah, don't worry. I listen to everything and I'm watching everything. As long as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows everything, don't be worried about anything. Don't be worried about anything. This trip was really amazing. I don't know, in this short time, this I will call it, what I have said now is only introduction to Al-Misra wal-Mi'raj. But what we want to get, As-Salihin, they said, the more humbleness you show, the more you will get Mi'rajul Arwah. Mi'rajul Arwah. They said, Al-Salihin, physically they are with the people, but their ruh connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rabi'atul Adawiyya radiyallahu anha, a man came to her house, he's a thief, churi, to steal. And he wants to kill her. She was praying. When he wants to kill her, subhanAllah, his hand frozen. Cannot do anything until she finish. Salaamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. And then when she look, Allah, mashaAllah, alhamdulillah, I have a guest today in my house. Ahlan wa sahlan, salam at that time. He said, I'm not a guest. I am a thief. I'm just about to kill you. But Allah save you, subhanahu wa ta'ala, from me. She said, oh, you want something, that mean? He said, yes. Oh, yeah, I have. Come, sit. نصيحة. Come from what? نصيحة. From the sweetness of the tongue, because she has sweetness of the heart. If you talk and you have pure heart, your message will be from heart to heart, not from mouth only. Come from here, go. This one, Masoud, this one, Kalwar. Alas. Going back home, what the Imam said? Wallahi, it was a very nice night. How is it? He mentioned a few things, you know, but anyway, it was good, alhamdulillah. Maybe you remember the makan only, that's all. So from heart to heart, that they call them arbab al-qulub. Sayyidina Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani, when they ask him about his miracle, the biggest miracle, of course, the Imam al-Nawawi, he said, we have not heard about someone who has miracle like Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani. He's a bit tawatur. From many directions reached to us. Sayyidina Shaykh Abdul, when they ask him, what is your biggest miracle? He said, ihya al-qulub al-mayita, reviving the dead hearts. Someone away from the path, bring him to the path. This is considered your miracle. Nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when she started advising him, he felt Allah's gone. When he came, he asked, she gave him sijada. He went outside the house, the whole night tahajjud. Now he found something different. Sweetness of taqwa, sweetness of Rabb al-Dunya wal-Akhirah. Without section of other things. At the morning, the king sent to her, the Khalifa, a gift, camel, contained a camel carrying two boxes, gift to Rabi' al-Adawiyya, min al-Awliya. So she said to the thief, brother, alhamdulillah, last night, you know, today halal, these two for you. Allah, mashallah, Allah accept his dua. Tawbah nasuh, you know, immediately rizq. But you know what he said? He said, I don't want it. Huh? Why? He said, last night my heart was full love to dunya. Today my heart full love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I want to spend this few. So he said to the minister who brought the gift, said, brother, take it back. So the minister said, what is happening here? This is a gift from the Sul Khalifa, the Sultan. You want to offer this person, he doesn't want, and now you want me to. What are you talking? You have to understand. Jazakallah khairan. She said to him, brother, I have not asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a single thing for this dunya. You will think I will ask the creatures? If I never ask the creator, I will ask the creatures? Yani, even you might ask. Things you might ask for and things might come. Because you see, when we ask Allah for what we want. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kind to you, He will give you what you need, not what we want. When you take your children to toy shop, if you say to them, take whatever you want, oh, they will take so much things, end of the day. Huh? This one break, that one. No, nothing. But if you say, take one, they will go round and round and they will choose one which really they want, they need. Not what they want, they which they need. The dunya for us can be for anyone. But you have to get from this dunya the hasana, which Allah mentioned, رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَا. But the hasana of dunya is the bridge for the hasana of akhirah. What is it here? Al-ikhlas. This is your humbleness, your tawadu. Sayyidina Rasulullah, because of that, he have got from Allah what he have got. And when he came back, don't think he was more proud. He was more humble, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The more Allah give him, the more humble he becomes, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah bless us to follow his example. He's the greatest sunnah to follow him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to get Allah's love, subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to know the meaning of these examples and apply it in our life. And we have to teach our children about it, to know what the meaning of salat. Don't say to your children, if you never pray, shaitan will come and, you know, they will be in a... Tell them, you love me? Yes. You love your father? Yes. You love your mother? Yes. Okay. You want to be with me always? Yes. Let us pray together now so that we will be in Akhirah also together. Mm-hmm. We have to have the hikmah to teach them the meaning of salah. This salah will keep the connection with Allah strong. Bi-idhnillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah grant us rahmah and barakah. May Allah bless us with the humbleness that he mentioned. May Allah make Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam always our biggest example. And may Allah bless us to understand the meaning of this life before we leave it. The meaning of this life to say that it belongs to him. Take from this life what you can be with you in your grave. And the best thing, al-amalu salih. Choose the deeds. Choose your connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let your sila be the decide for you. If Allah likes you to do, if Allah pleased with what you are going to do, do it. Allah wants you to forgive. Allah please if you forgive others, do it. Allah will be pleased if you're generous, do it. So that we'll get from him the best for our dunya and akhirah, inshallah. May Allah bless you all. May Allah protect you all. And may Allah give barakah for Nashrul Quran. And may Allah bless them with barakah, taqwa, hidayah. And may Allah bring the name of Nashrul Quran everywhere in this world, inshallah. And the people to follow this example. So that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make us understand the blessing of this organization being here in Malaysia, inshallah. And we, well, this is something we have to be proud of, because we're proud of Al-Quran Al-Kareem. That is this Kitabullah, not anything else. May Allah grant us all Rahman Barakah, the meaning of Isra al-Mi'raj, and may Allah grant us the barakah of As-Salat. And we are heading to Ramadan. Ya Allah, help us to understand the meaning of Taraweeh, the spiritual meaning of Taraweeh, not the number of rak'at of Taraweeh, and fight each other because of that. Bless us, Ya Allah, and make this Salat our Mi'raj to you. Let our heart be humble. Ya Allah, we want our heart to be in a position of Qiyam and Ruku' and Sujood, not only physically. Bless us, Ya Allah, with purity of heart. So whenever we talk, the people will understand our language, the language of heart, and they accept it from us, and our life will be ease. Husband and wife, parents and children, boss and employers. And may Allah grant us subhanahu wa ta'ala rahmah fi dunya wal akhirah. Rabbana taqabbal minna du'ana ya kareem, warhamna bi rahmatin minka ya raheem. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وصلي وسلم وبارك على حبيبك ومولانا وسيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم والحمد لله رب العالمين جزاكم الله خير.